Basically, when you practice, you should practice like what you practice bowl in a match. You should create a match environment in a match. You should go and talk to the captain, your batsman, and then set your field. This is my field. I'm going to bowl these balls, so that you practice like that. There's no point in running up and down every day and then bowling for 45 minutes to 1 hour and not thinking about how you bowl in a match. But what you are doing in practice has to be repeated in a match. So you have to practice as though that you are playing a match. See, basically what Dennis Lee used to say, practice never makes you perfect. Perfect practice makes you perfect. So you have to try all the variations in your practice, like Yorkers, slower ones, bouncers, bowling length balls. So this will help you to bowl these different type of deliveries even when you are playing in a match, even when you are getting hit. Particularly after the emergence of this T20 cricket, even if you are bowling a good length ball, it is hit outside the ground. But you should know exactly what length to bowl and then what line to bowl. So you should be able to immediately change without losing your confidence, change the line, change the length, and then maybe try to unsettle the batsman with a bouncer. You are allowed to bowl one bouncer in a one day or T20 game, or a very good Yorker, a very good disguised slower one, or a slow bouncer. You should try all these variations, which will keep you in rhythm. So it is very difficult for any bowler not to get hit. Someday or other, one will get hit. But the thing is, if you practice well in practice, then these variations will come good for you, because no batsman in T20 or one day would like to have too many dot balls. So you create pressure through bowling dot balls, then automatically the batsman will fall into your trap. This is one way you can keep your rhythm going, so that even if the batsman hit one or two fours, still you can back up your bowling and come back into the game.